The King's forces have clashed with the Darkspawn several times, but here is where the bulk of the Horde will show itself. There are only a few Grey Wardens within Ferelden at the moment, but all of us are here. This blight must be stopped, here and now. If it spreads to the north, Ferelden will fall.
Ho there, Duncan.
King Kaelan. I didn't expect a...
A royal welcome? I was beginning to worry you'd miss all the fun.
Not if I could help it, Your Majesty.
Then I'll have the mighty Duncan at my side in battle after all. Glorious. The other wardens told me you'd found a promising recruit. I take it this is she?
Allow me to introduce you, Your Majesty.
There's no need to be so formal, Duncan. We'll be shedding blood together after all. Ho there, friend. Might I know your name? Pleased to meet you. The Grey Wardens are desperate to bolster their numbers, and I, for one, am glad to help them. You are Dalish, are you not? I hear your people possess remarkable skill and honor. I wish I knew more, but your people aren't exactly fond of mine, for good reason. I tell you this, you are very welcome here. The Grey Wardens will benefit greatly with you amongst them. I'm sorry to cut this short, but I should return to my tent. Loghain waits eagerly to bore me with his strategies.
Your uncle sends his greetings and reminds you that Redcliffe forces could be here in less than a week.
Ha! Eamon just wants in on the glory. We've won 3 battles against these monsters, and tomorrow should be no different. I'm not even sure this is a true blight. There are plenty of darkspawn on the field, but alas, we've seen no sign of an archdemon.
Disappointed, Your Majesty?
I'd hoped for a war like in the tales. A king riding with the fabled Grey Wardens against a tainted god. But I suppose this will have to do. I must go before Loghain sends out a search party. Farewell, Grey Wardens.
What the king said is true. They've won several battles against the Darkspawn here. Despite the victory so far, the Darkspawn horde grows larger with each passing day. By now, they look to outnumber us. I know there is an archdemon behind this, but I cannot ask the king to act solely on my feeling. Yet not enough to wait for reinforcements from the Grey Wardens of Orlais. He believes our legend alone makes him invulnerable. Our numbers in Ferelden are too few. We must do what we can, and look to Terran Loghain to make up the difference. To that end, we should proceed with the joining ritual without delay. Feel free to explore the camp here as you wish. All I ask is that you do not leave it for the time being. There is another Grey Warden in the camp by the name of Alistair. When you're ready, seek him out and tell him it's time to summon the other recruits. Until then, I have business I must attend to. You may find me at the Grey Warden tent on the other side of this bridge, should you need to.
What is it now? Haven't Grey Wardens asked more than enough of the Circle?
I simply came to deliver a message from the revered mother, Sir Mage. She desires your presence.
What her reverence desires is of no concern to me. I am busy helping the Grey Wardens, by the King's orders, I might add.
Should I have asked her to write a note?
Tell her I will not be harassed in this manner.
Yes, I was harassing you by delivering a message.
Your glibness does you no credit.
Here I thought we were getting along so well. I was even going to name one of my children after you. The grumpy one.
Enough. I will speak to the woman if I must. Get out of my way, fool.
You know, one good thing about the Blight is how it brings people together. It's like a party. We could all stand in a circle and hold hands. That would give the Darkspawn something to think about. Wait, we haven't met, have we? I don't suppose you happen to be another mage. And that makes you Duncan's new recruit, I suppose. Glad to meet you. As the junior member of the Order, I'll be accompanying you when you prepare for the joining. Right, that was the name. You know, it just occurred to me that there have never been many women in the Grey Wardens. I wonder why that is. I'm getting that impression.
So I'm curious. Have you ever actually encountered Darkspawn before?
I've only fought them once up close. And that was before the battles here started, which Duncan has kept me out of so far. Tell me, did you find them as monstrous as I did?
I'd read so much, but it just can't prepare you. I don't look forward to seeing them again.
Anyhow, whenever you're ready, let's get back to Duncan. I imagine he's eager to get things started. With the mage. The Circle is here at the King's request, and the Chantry doesn't like that one bit. They just love letting mages know how unwelcome they are, which puts me in a bit of an awkward position. I was once a Templar.
You don't know? Quick version then. The Chantry tries to control mages because they're dangerous, so they keep Templars that train to hunt down and kill apostates.
That's what I was being trained as when Duncan recruited me 6 months ago. I'm sure the revered mother meant it as an insult, sending me as her messenger, and the mage picked right up on that. I never would have agreed to deliver it, but Duncan says we're all to cooperate and get along. Apparently, they didn't get the same speech.
Davith and Sir Jory are here in the camp. Have you met them?
Keep an eye out. Maybe we'll see one of them.
You do? Huh. That's a switch. If you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, lead on. Yes? As I said, I was trained as a Templar before Duncan recruited me about 6 months ago. The Chantry raised me. And becoming a Templar was a decision made for me a long time ago. Duncan saw I wasn't happy and figured my training against mages could double for fighting Darkspawn. Now, here I stand, a proud Grey Warden. The Grand Cleric wouldn't have let me go if Duncan never forced the issue. I'll always be grateful to him. It just wasn't for me. I believe in the Maker well enough, but I never wanted to devote my life to the Chantry. I spent years in that Chantry, hopelessly resigned to my fate. Duncan was the first person who cared what I wanted. He risked a lot of trouble with the Grand Cleric to help me. Or maybe he just happens to be a good man. What about? So I imagine, what would you like to know? Well, let's see. Surely you've heard of Weisshaupt Fortress? The great eyrie carved into the White Cliffs far off in the Anderfels? That's where the Grey Wardens once kept their griffins. The griffins died out, however, and our numbers have dwindled since the last blight. There's only a handful left in Ferelden. A few more in other nations. The others are camped with the King's soldiers in the valley. The King's given us a position of honor at the vanguard, despite our small numbers. I think Kaelin is actually excited to ride into battle with us. Maybe he thinks that's what his father would have done. King Marek, Kaelin's father, reaffirmed the power the Grey Wardens were given during the Blights. In practice, we can't conscript too often without hurting our cause. We were exiled from Ferelden once. Best not to let that happen again. The Grey Wardens are warriors without equal. Darkspawn threatened to destroy the world four times over, each time the Grey Wardens led mankind to victory. Nobody knows more about Darkspawn, and nobody's better equipped to deal with them. You'll see. Trust me. I don't know if I'd go that far. Duncan says the Grey Wardens do whatever is necessary to protect mankind from Darkspawn. That means some pretty extreme things. Whatever it takes to bring victory. You want to ask me about something else? Of course. You want the Chantry's version or the truth? The truth is, we don't really know. They come up from the ground, and that's as far as we've gotten. According to the Chant of Light, the Maker imprisoned the old gods underground long ago, as punishment for tricking mankind into worshipping them. The old gods still whispered to some men and taught them magic. These men became the Magisters of the Tevinter Empire. The Magisters used their gift to enter the Golden City, tainting it and themselves. They were cast out by the Maker and became the first Darkspawn. They fled underground, bringing their taint to their gods. The tainted old gods were the archdemons who rose from their prisons and led the Darkspawn against the world. Yes, and it nearly wiped us out. When defeated, the Darkspawn flee back underground and seek out another old god to taint, thus bringing another blight. We haven't seen it yet. People are beginning to think this is just an unusually large Darkspawn raid without an Archdemon to unify them. But seriously, the Archdemon could be in the wilds or underground. It could be hiding. Just because it hasn't shown itself doesn't mean it isn't out there. They've controlled the deep roads ever since they defeated the Dwarven Kingdoms. Even if we invaded, we can only chase them so far. The old gods were dragons, so the stories say. Big ones. Intelligent, even. The Tevinter Empire had big statues of them. Each dragon had a name and a place in the cosmos. It's all very intricate. The archdemons may not be the old gods, but they're definitely dragons. The Grey Wardens killed so many Darkspawn by the end of the last blight. People decided they were gone for good. Of course. We chop off the snake's head. It's the only way. According to texts, the most famous Grey Warden leader, Garahel, killed the Archdemon Underarl in personal combat at the Battle of Aesley to end the last blight. Without the Archdemon to command them, the Darkspawn flee back underground. The Grey Wardens keep watch. We feel the Darkspawn when they come. You'll understand after the joining, if you... Well, you'll understand. Not to mention people start to notice when Darkspawn pour out of the wilds and taint everything around them. Just a guess. Thousands? Tens of thousands? They've had centuries to build up their numbers. You want to ask me about something else? Then let's get a move on, shall we? Yes? What about? Duncan is the leader of the Grey Wardens in Ferelden, which he would say doesn't mean much, as there aren't many of us here. Yet, beyond that, he's a good man, a good judge of character. I owe him a lot. What about you? What do you think of him? That sounds familiar. He's done the best he can with what little he has. And that includes me, I guess. You want to ask me about something else? There's not a lot I can tell you. We go and collect Darkspawn blood, and then you'll hear everything. Look, I can't tell you much, all right? The joining is very unpleasant. I wish I could forget it, but I can't. I don't envy what you're going to have to go through. You learn why it's a secret. The joining is the price we pay, all of us, for being able to defeat the Darkspawn. You can't refuse. That's the spirit. If becoming a Grey Warden were easy, we wouldn't recruit the best. You want to ask me about something else? The one tomorrow. I'll tell you, it's Tan Loghain we should be looking to win it, not the king. Caelan just wants his place in history, but Taryn is planning the strategy. That's my opinion, anyway. I guess I should be thankful the king favors us Grey Wardens. But I know who's keeping the lid on the pot. You know, that's a good question. The other Grey Wardens are riding into battle with the king. I don't know if you'll be with them. We're at the edge of the Qorkari Wilds, the eye of the Blight Storm, right where the Horde will be coming. Ostagar itself is an excellent defensive position. The Wilders were pushed back from here time and again in ancient days. I'm sure Tern Loghain has the battle planned to the last detail. Still, no Blight has ever been defeated with so little cost. If we don't break the Horde here, Duncan says it will spread until it engulfs all of Ferelden. Then it will take an alliance of nations to fight it, which would be bad. Neither the king nor the Tern really seems to believe this is a real blight, however. You want to ask me about something else? Then let's get a move on, shall we?
You found Alistair, did you? Good. I'll assume you're ready to begin preparations. Assuming, of course, that you're quite finished riling up mages, Alistair.
What can I say? The revered mother ambushed me. The way she wields guilt, they should stick her in the army.
She forced you to sass the mage, did she? We cannot afford to antagonize anyone, Alistair. We don't need to give anyone more ammunition against us.
I apologize, Duncan. I'll go collect who we're missing. This is Ser Jorri, a knight from Redcliff.
How do you do?
And this, of course, is the recruit that Duncan said he was bringing.
Now then, since you're all here, we can begin. You four will be heading into the Qorkari Wilds to perform two tasks. The first is to obtain 3 vials of darkspawn blood, 1 for each recruit. There was once a Grey Warden archive in the Wilds, abandoned long ago when we could no longer afford to maintain such remote outposts. It has recently come to our attention that some scrolls have been left behind, magically sealed to protect them. Alistair, I want you to retrieve these scrolls if you can. Old treaties, if you're curious. Promises of support made to the Grey Wardens long ago. They were once considered only formalities. With so many having forgotten their commitments to us, I suspect it may be a good idea to have something to remind them with. It's possible the scrolls may have been destroyed or even stolen, though the seal's magic should have protected them. Only a Grey Warden can break such a seal.
I don't understand. Why leave such things in a ruin if they're so valuable?
It was assumed that we would someday return. A great many things were assumed that have not held true. Watch over your charges, Alistair. Return quickly and safely.
We will.
Then may the Maker watch over your path. I will see you when you return.
Well, well. What have we here? Are you a vulture, I wonder? A scavenger, poking amidst a corpse whose bones were long since cleaned? Or merely an intruder, come into these darkspawn-filled wilds of mine in search of easy prey? What say you, Scavenger or intruder? 'Tis a tower no longer. The wilds have obviously claimed this desiccated corpse. I have watched your progress for some time. Where do they go, I wondered? Why are they here? And now you disturb ashes none have touched for so long. Why is that?
Don't answer her. She looks chastened, and that means others may be nearby.
Oh, you fear barbarians will swoop down upon you.
Yes, swooping is bad.
She's a witch of the wild, she is. She'll turn us into toads.
Witch of the Wilds. Such idle fancies, those legends. Have you no minds of your own? You there. Women do not frighten like little boys. Tell me your name and I shall tell you mine. Now Now that is a proper civil greeting, even here in the wilds. You may call me Morrigan. Shall I guess your purpose? You sought something in that chest? Something that is here no longer?
Here no longer? You stole them, didn't you? You're some kind of sneaky witch thief.
How very eloquent. How does one steal from dead men?
Quite easily, it seems. Those documents are Grey Warden property, and I suggest you return them.
I will not, for 'twas not I who removed them. Invoke a name that means nothing here any longer if you wish. I am not threatened. 'Twas my mother, in fact. There is a sensible request. I like you.
I'd be careful. First it's, I like you, but then zap, frog time.
She'll put us all in the pot, she will. Just you watch.
If the pot's warmer than this forest, it'd be a nice change.
Follow me then, if it pleases you.
So you return from the wilds. Have you been successful? Good. I've had the Circle mages preparing. With the blood you've retrieved, we can begin the joining immediately. I will not lie. We Grey Wardens pay a heavy price to become what we are. Fate may decree that you pay your price now rather than later. If only such secrecy were unnecessary and all understood the necessity of such sacrifice. Sadly, that will never be so.
Let's go then. I'm anxious to see this joining now.
I agree. Let's have it done.
Then let us begin. Alistair, take them to the old temple.
The more I hear about this joining, the less I like it.
Are you blubbering again?
Why all these damn tests? Have I not earned my place?
Maybe it's tradition. Maybe they're just trying to annoy you.
I only know that my wife is in Hyever with a child on the way. If they had warned me, it just doesn't seem fair.
Would you have come if they'd warned you? Maybe that's why they don't. The Wardens do what they must, right?
Including sacrificing us?
I'd sacrifice a lot more if I knew it would end the Blight. You saw those Darkspawn tonight. Wouldn't you die to protect your pretty wife from them? Maybe you'll die. Maybe we'll all die. If nobody stops the Darkspawn, we'll die for sure.
I've just never faced a foe I could not engage with my blade.
At last, we come to the joining. The Grey Wardens were founded during the First Blight, when humanity stood on the verge of annihilation. So it was that the first Grey Wardens drank of Darkspawn blood and mastered their taint.
We're going to drink the blood of those creatures.
As the first Grey Wardens did before us, as we did before you. This is the source of our power and our victory.
Those who survive the joining become immune to the taint. We can sense it in the Darkspawn and use it to slay the Archdemon.
We speak only a few words prior to the joining, but these words have been said since the first. Alistair, if you would.
Join us, brothers and sisters. Join us in the shadows where we stand vigilant. Join us as we carry the duty that cannot be forsworn. And should you perish, know that your sacrifice will not be forgotten, and that one day, we shall join you.
Davith, step forward.
Yeah.
Step forward, Jory.
But I have a wife, a child. Had I known...
There is no turning back.
No. You ask too much. There is no glory in this.
I am sorry. But the joining is not yet complete. You are called upon to submit yourself to the taint for the greater good. From this moment forth, you are a Grey Warden.
Two more deaths. In my joining, only one of us died, but it was horrible. I'm glad at least one of you made it through.
How do you feel? Jory was warned that there was no turning back, as were you all. When he went for his blade, however, he left me no choice. It brought me no pleasure to end his life. The Blight demands sacrifices from us all. Thankfully, you stand here as proof they are not all made in vain.
Did you have dreams? I had terrible dreams after my joining.
Such dreams come when you begin to sense the Darkspawn, as we all do. That and many other things can be explained in the months to come.
Before I forget, there is one last part to your joining. We take some of that blood and put it in a pendant. Something to remind us of those who didn't make it this far.
Take some time. When you're ready, I'd like you to accompany me to a meeting with the King. The King is discussing strategy for the upcoming battle. I am not sure why he has requested your presence. The meeting is to the west, down the stairs. Please attend as soon as you're able.
Loghain, my decision is final. I will stand by the Grey Wardens in this assault.
You risk too much, Caelan. A Darkspawn horde is too dangerous for you to be playing hero on the front lines.
If that's the case, perhaps we should wait for the Orlesian forces to join us after all.
I must repeat my protest to your fool notion that we need the Orlesians to defend ourselves.
It is not a fool notion. Our arguments with the Orlesians are a thing of the past. And you will remember who is king.
How fortunate Marek did not live to see his son ready to hand Ferelden over to those who enslaved us for a century.
Then our current forces will have to suffice, won't they? Duncan, are your men ready for battle?
They are, Your Majesty.
And this is the recruit I met earlier on the road? I understand congratulations are in order. Every Grey Warden is needed now. You should be honored to join their ranks.
Your fascination with glory and legends will be your undoing, Caelan. We must attend to reality.
Fine. Speak your strategy. The Grey Wardens and I draw the Darkspawn into charging our lines, and then?
You will alert the tower to light the beacon, signaling my men to charge from
cover. To flank the Darkspawn, I remember. This is the Tower of Ishal in the ruins, yes? Well, who shall light this beacon?
I have a few men stationed there. It's not a dangerous task, but it is vital.
Then we should send our best. Send Alistair and the new Grey Warden to make sure it's done.
You rely on these Grey Wardens too much. Is that truly wise?
Enough of your conspiracy theories, Loghain. Grey Wardens battle the Blight no matter where they're from.
Your Majesty, you should consider the possibility of the Archdemon appearing.
There have been no signs of any dragons in the wilds.
Isn't that what your men are here for, Duncan?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Your Majesty, the tower and its beacon are unnecessary. The Circle of Magi...
We will not trust any lives to your spells, Mage. Save them for the Darkspawn.
Enough! This plan will suffice. The Grey Wardens will light the beacon.
Thank you, Loghain. I cannot wait for that glorious moment.
The Grey Wardens battle beside the King of Ferelden to stem the tide of evil.
Yes, Kaelin. A glorious moment for us all.
You heard the plan. You and Alistair will go to the Tower of Ishal and ensure the beacon is lit.
What? I won't be in the battle.
This is by the King's personal request, Alistair. If the beacon is not lit, Taren Loghain's men won't know when to charge.
So he needs two Grey Wardens standing up there holding the torch, just in case, right?
That is not your choice. If King Kaelin wishes Grey Wardens to ensure the beacon is lit, then Grey Wardens will be there. We must do whatever it takes to destroy the Darkspawn, exciting or no.
I get it. Just so you know, if the King ever asks me to put on a dress and dance the Remigold, I'm drawing the line. Darkspawn or no. I have my dignity. Well, some.
The tower is on the other side of the gorge from the King's camp, the way we came when we arrived. You'll need to cross the gorge and head through the gate and up to the tower entrance. From the top, you'll overlook the entire valley. We will signal you when the time is right. Alistair will know what to look for. Stay with the Terran's men and guard the tower. If you are needed, we will send word.
We soil our drawers, that's what.
If it does, leave it to us. I want no heroics from either of you. Then I must join the others. From here, you tour on your own. Remember, you are both Grey Wardens. I expect you to be worthy of that title.
Duncan, may the Maker watch over you.
May he watch over us all.
For Ferelden!
Let's cross the bridge and get to the Tower of Ishal.
Your eyes finally open. Mother shall be pleased. You were injured, and then Mother rescued you. Do you not remember? Mother managed to save you and your friend, though 'twas a close call. What is important is that you both live. The man who was to respond to your signal quit the field. The Darkspawn won your battle. Those he abandoned were massacred. Your friend, he is not taking it well. The suspicious dim-witted one who was with you before, yes. He is outside by the fire. Mother asked to see you when you awoke. Yes, but I expect you shall be fine. The Darkspawn did nothing Mother could not heal. I do not know. She rarely tells me her plans. I will stay and make something to eat.
See, here is your fellow Grey Warden. You worry too much, young man.
You... you're alive. I thought you were dead for sure. Oh, this doesn't seem real. If it weren't for Morrigan's mother, we'd be dead on top of that tower.
Do not talk about me as if I am not present, lad.
I didn't mean... But what do we call you? You've never told us your name.
Names are pretty, but useless. The chastened folk call me Flemeth. I suppose it will do.
The Flemeth? From the legends? Daveth was right. You're the Witch of the Wilds, aren't you?
And what does that mean? I know a bit of magic, and it has served you both well, has it not? Must I? Age and power are relative. It depends on who is asking. Compared to you, yes, on both counts.
Then why didn't you save Duncan? He was our leader.
I am sorry for your Duncan, but your grief must come later. In the dark shadows before you take vengeance, as my mother once said. Duty must come now. It has always been the Grey Warden's duty to unite the lands against the Blight. Or did that change when I wasn't looking?
That doesn't make any sense. Why would he do it?
Now that is a good question. Men's hearts hold shadows darker than any tainted creature. Perhaps he believes the Blight is an army he can outmaneuver. Perhaps he does not see that the evil behind it is the true threat.
The Archdemon. Kaelin already summoned them. They'll come if they can, but I expect Loghain has already taken steps to stop them. We must assume they won't arrive in time. The throne? He's the Queen's father. Still, I can't see how he'll get away with murder.
You speak as if he would be the first king to gain his throne that way. Grow up, boy.
If Al-Eamon knew what he did, he would never stand for it. The Landsmeet would never stand for it. There would be civil war. I suppose. Al-Eamon wasn't at Ostagar. He still has all his men. And he was Kaelin's uncle. I know him. He's a good man, respected in the Landsmeet. Of course, we could go to Redcliff and appeal to him for help. Of course, the treaties. Grey Wardens can demand aid from dwarves, elves, mages, and other places. They're obligated to help us during a blight.
I may be old, but dwarves, elves, mages, this Arl-Eamon, and who knows what else. This sounds like an army to me.
So can we do this? Go to Redcliff and these other places and build an army?
So you are set then, ready to be Grey Wardens. No, thank you. You are the Grey Wardens here, not I. Now, before you go, there is yet one more thing I can offer you.
The stew is bubbling, Mother dear. Shall we have two guests for the eve, or none?
The Grey Wardens are leaving shortly, girl. And you will be joining them.
Such a shame. What?
You heard me, girl. The last time I looked, you had ears. Her magic will be useful. Even better, she knows the wilds and how to get past the Horde.
Have I no say in this?
You have been itching to get out of the wilds for years. Here is your chance. As for you, Wardens, consider this repayment for your lives.
Not to look a gift horse in the mouth, but won't this add to our problems? Out of the wilds, she's an apostate.
If you do not wish help from us illegal mages, young man, perhaps I should have left you on that tower.
Point taken.
Mother, this is not how I wanted this. I'm not even ready.
You must be ready. Alone, these two must unite Ferelden against the Darkspawn. They need you, Morrigan. Without you, they will surely fail, and all will perish under the Blight. Even I.
I understand.
And you, Wardens, do you understand? I give you that which I value above all in this world. I do this because you must succeed.
Allow me to get my things, if you please. I am at your disposal, Grey Wardens. I suggest a village north of the wilds as our first destination. It is not far, and you will find much you need there. Or, if you prefer, I shall simply be your silent guide. The choice is yours. From the way he glares, I imagine that answer is clear.
Do you really want to take her along because her mother says so? I guess you're right. The Grey Wardens have always taken allies where they could find them.
I am so pleased to have your approval. Farewell, Mother. Do not forget the stew on the fire. I would hate to return to a burned-down hut.
Bah! 'Tis far more likely you will return to see this entire area, along with my hut, swallowed up by the Blight.
All I meant was...
Yes, I know. Do try to have fun, dear.
I think he was out there looking for you. He's chosen you. Mabari are like that. They call it imprinting.
Does this mean we're going to have this mangy beast following us about now? Wonderful.
He's not mangy.
Well, there it is. Lothering. Pretty as a painting.
Ah, so you have finally decided to rejoin us, have you? Falling on your blade in grief seemed like too much trouble, I take it.
Is my being upset so hard to understand? Have you never lost someone important to you? Just what would you do if your mother died?
Before or after I stopped laughing.
Right, very creepy. Forget I asked. Yes, I know. I was just thinking.
No wonder it took so long, then.
Oh, I get it. This is the part where we're shocked to discover how you've never had a friend your entire life.
I can be friendly when I desire to. Alas, desiring to be more intelligent does not make it so.
Anyway, I thought we should talk about where we intend to go first. I agree. Have you looked at them? There are three main groups that we have treaties for. The Dalish Elves, the Dwarves of Orzammar, and the Circle of Magi. I also still think that Ahriman is our best bet for help. We might even want to go to him first. Short of leaving Ferelden to seek them out, the only place to send word to would be Weishaupt Fortress. And that's thousands of miles away. I can give you directions, if you like. There must be other Dalish in Ferelden, in fact I'm sure of it. If we head eastward, towards the Brasilian Forest, we should hear word of one of the clans that wanders that area. Hopefully they will still be there. Then you have a plan. Fair enough. Let's head into the village whenever you're ready. What do you need? You don't have to do that. I know you didn't know him as long as I did. I should have handled it better. Duncan warned me right from the beginning that this could happen. Any of us could die in battle. I shouldn't have lost it. Not when so much is riding on us. Not with the Blight and everything. I'm sorry. I'd like to have a proper funeral for him. Maybe once this is all done, if we're still alive. I don't think he had any family to speak of. I suppose he did. It probably sounds stupid, but part of me wishes I was with him, in the battle. I feel like I abandoned him. Yes, I know. I think he came from Hyeva, or so he said. Maybe I'll go up there sometime. See about putting up something in his honor. I don't know. The Dalish don't practice cremation, do they? How do your people honor your dead? That sounds quite beautiful. Life springing from death. Thank you. Really, I mean it. It was good to talk about it, at least a little. I'd like that. So would he, I think. Bad dreams, huh? Well, it is real, sort of. You see, part of being a Grey Warden is being able to hear the Darkspawn. That's what your dream was, hearing them. The Archdemon, it talks to the Horde, and we feel it just as they do. That's why we know this is really a Blight. I don't know if it's really a dragon, but it sure looks like one. But yes, that's the Archdemon. It takes a bit, but eventually you can block the dreams out. Some of the older Grey Wardens say they can understand the Archdemon a bit, but I sure can't. Anyhow, when I heard you thrashing around, I thought I should tell you. It was scary at first for me too. That's what I'm here for. To deliver unpleasant news and witty one-liners. Anyhow, you're up now, right? Let's pull up camp and get a move on. What do you need? Ask away. Essentially, they're trained to fight. The Chantry would tell you that the Templars exist simply to defend. But don't let them fool you. They're an army. The other main purpose for a Templar is, of course, to hunt mages. To that end, we train in talents that drain mana and disrupt spells. Perhaps, but there usually isn't much of an opportunity. The Chantry keeps a close rein on its Templars. We are given Lyrium to help develop our magical talents, you see. Which means we become addicted. And since the Chantry controls the Lyrium trade with the dwarves, well, I'm sure you can put two and two together. Thankfully, no. You only start receiving Lyrium once you've taken your vows. You don't need Lyrium in order to learn the Templar talents. Lyrium just makes Templar's talents more effective, or so I was told. Maybe it doesn't even do that. The Chantry usually doesn't let their Templars get away either, so they can spread their secrets. I'm a bit of an exception. Lucky me. What do you need? Ask away. I suppose I could, but I really would rather not. When the Grand Cleric let Duncan recruit me, she made me swear never to reveal Templar secrets outside of the Chantry. I'd rather not go back on my word. Ask me later, perhaps. Maybe I'll change my mind. This is not something small you're asking, after all.